in the past, there have been specific robotic missions for specific purposes. For example, an orbiter around a planet giving you a global reconnaissance, or a rover on a planet giving you a very local reconnaissance. The idea is, though, to mimic a field geologist, which means an approach that allows you to go from a global perspective to a regional perspective to a local perspective. And that leads you directly to a distributed system where basically, instead of putting all the smarts on one entity, you basically distribute this entity into many entities to have redundancy and robustness for the missions, and also to enhance the intelligence which is inherent to these missions. I'm Dr. Wolfgang Fink. I'm an associate professor in the Edward and Maria Keonjian Endowed Chair at the University of Arizona in the College of Engineering. I've also spent almost 20 years at the California Institute of Technology and 10 years at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory. So as you can already see from these many affiliations, my research areas are quite diverse yet connected. On the one side, we have autonomous systems at large for space exploration, hazardous environments on Earth. And then we have biomedical healthcare technologies. So everything in and around vision and eyes, retinal implants, examination devices, mobile examination devices for people in remote areas, and so forth. And as a third area, we have multidimensional optimization, which actually services all the previous areas. At this conference, we are presenting on a new paradigm, which is called tier-scalable reconnaissance. It's a paradigm for autonomous robotic exploration of hazardous environment and also space. So, for example, you have an orbiter governing a whole planet. The orbiter deploys aerial platforms if the planet supports an atmosphere, such as blimps, helicopters, quadcopters, and so forth. And those aerial platforms, in turn, submit or deploy miniaturized, redundant, expendable rovers on the surface of a planet to get the in-situ reconnaissance. From a more commercial or scientific exploration point of view, the next steps are to have space missions while having the same overall payload. You now distribute the payload to many entities such that you have mission redundancy, and you can actually afford to go to high-risk areas on planets where the real science lies. That's where, for example, you look for life on another planet, for example, Mars. You go for methane outgassing on Mars. You may explore the hydrocarbon lakes on Titan, which is Saturn's moon, and so forth. Those are scenarios which, up to now, have not been possible with current mission paradigms. Hence, we have been proposing and propagating and also working on the tier-scalable reconnaissance paradigm. The inherent challenge for the tier-scalable reconnaissance paradigm is to actually enable the true autonomy in such a systems architecture. You have many agents, space-borne, airborne, ground, and subsurface, and the idea is how they can all function in concert with each other in the absence of human control. While you can still have a human override if you desire so, the idea is, though, for distant planets, where the speed of light simply prohibits real-time commanding, that you can actually have the system conduct its own science, redirect its own agents, redeploy the agents, and get the science, and then send the interesting science results back to Earth.